Dude, are you serious? I just bought 100 puts on Tesla on Friday when it was dropping like a rock. Dude, you can't be serious telling me that Tesla shares are about to go higher. You must have been smoking with Elon Musk again. Guys, I am actually dead serious. I wish I was joking. But that, of course, refers to a short-term move in Tesla. I do believe that the shares are going to go short-term-wise a little bit higher from where they're at right now. And we're going to go a little bit into more detail as far as that goes and particular strategy that you may want to utilize. However, in this particular video, I would like to share one simple rule that I think would be helpful to anyone that's trading stocks, options, short-term, whether you're trading stocks or options long-term. This is something that you can probably benefit from. Okay, so the simple rule is this. It's too late to actually short a stock or a commodity when everybody becomes a bear. This is the time to lock in gains and wait for a better entry. Look, guys, I've studied many, many successful traders, and I've started realizing that they did not make money by participating in the move after the majority of the move has taken place. So if you've been following this channel, if you've been subscribed to our alerts, if you've taken our chart course, then you would know that we actually try to analyze the charts to predict the moves before they actually take place. See, when the move becomes apparent to everyone, oh my God, look at this. This thing is just keeps dropping. I need to be buying some puts. Well, at that point, it's actually too late oftentimes to be getting into a position. And sometimes, you know, you may get lucky and you benefit because the stock may just drop a little bit further, but you're not going to be able to produce gains to the extent of 500, 600, or even 2,000%, as we have shown you here on this channel. So as easy and as tempting as it appears sometimes, when something drops, you naturally just want to look at it and think, oh my God, with all the bad news, this thing is definitely dropping under 200. You guys have probably no idea how many comments I've received over the last, you know, couple of hours in the trading session on Friday from people saying, oh my God, this thing is just, it's going to crash. It's going to go below 200. It's going to 100. Look, for a lot of, for a long period of time on this channel, we're talking about shorting Tesla. And there's been numerous examples where we're able to catch drops between $50 and up to $100 in a very short time frame. And these trades did produce insane results. But again, the general rule is this. The general rule is this. It's too late to short something when everyone becomes a bear. So this is the time to lock in gains and wait for a better entry. And so this is exactly what we did. Here's the alert we sent out to our subscribers 2 days prior to Tesla dropping $42 or close to 15%. This alert was sent out on a Tuesday, as you can see, at 11:40 a.m. on Tuesday before the drop happened on Thursday night. And of course, when the market opened on Friday, the stock was trading the 260 to 70 level. We did send out the alert when the stock was trading at 298. So yes, we did not catch the ultimate top when the stock went in at about 311, 312. But at the point in time when we sent the alert, the 290 puts were trading at $3. On Friday, they were trading as high as 27, 28. So that produced for a nice return of about, 700% to 800%, depending where you were closing your position if you took action on this alert. And since we're on space, yeah, some of the other alerts we sent, Shopify, 150, 160 puts. The next day, they dropped very sharply to about 155, so you could have locked some nice gains there. Here's an alert that did not work out. It could potentially materialize in the longer time frame. CGC puts produced a nice gain. And Goldman Sachs puts, we were buying them at 43 cents. And Friday evening, Goldman Sachs stock pretty close to $224. So this return was actually, you were buying them for 43 cents. You could have closed out your position at $3.40. So this was an easy 800% gainer right here. Now, in the last 5 months, we did recommend 5 specific trades on Tesla. Now, notice at the point when we were recommending shorting Tesla, The majority of the investors were bullish, especially every time Tesla had some good news that propelled the stock higher, including the big time news with a fund and secured tweet when it made pretty much apparent that Tesla was going private. This was actually the day when we were shorting stocks, shorting the stock of Tesla. And at the end of this video, you guys can go in and review, because I go into a lot of details, specifically going into the details on the charts and why some of these trades were taken. Now, each one of those trades produced between 600% and 2,000% utilizing our weekly put option strategies that we focus here on this channel. Now, a few of those videos, again, I posted on this channel, and you can find them at the end of this video if you'd like to review them. If you've been a subscriber to our alerts, here's another thing that you would have also known. You would have known that when everybody was loading up on these put positions on Friday, September the 28th, when Tesla shares were dropping, $40 lower, okay, we actually did not. We did not send a single alert recommending our short-term or VIP subscribers to be shorting the stock. As a matter of fact, we were quite busy shorting other stocks that were going higher. See, as a short seller, and I've recorded a couple of videos on the psychology of short selling, you want to do exactly the opposite. You want to be shorting something in the higher trading range. In other words, when something goes higher, and you want to be closing your positions when the move lower actually takes place. A lot of people do exactly the opposite. And when you're shorting something in the lower trading range, then at that point, the probability that something could reverse, even if it's a fake bounce higher, the probability of that becomes actually greater, which makes it for a much riskier trade. So we were busy shorting some stocks that were actually going higher that day, and we're looking to take some significant profits over the next couple of weeks on some of these trades. So if you'd like to know what kind of trades there were, okay, you could simply sign up for our program, which begins with understanding the divergences when you're looking at a chart. Clearly, there's just a lot of noise, especially on Friday. If you were to turn on any financial channel, right, that's all they were talking about all day. How Elon Musk, the SEC, the this, the that, all kinds of stuff, right? All these opinions. Look, guys, they don't matter. If you want to be a successful short-term trader, what you need to do is you need to understand the charts. Because if you simply fall in the moves when the market has had already made those moves, then you're catching just little bits and pieces of these trades. If you want to capture the entire move, the entire, $30, $40 move, then you have to take action before the move takes place. And you can't arrive at those trading decisions if you're simply following the news. In other words, if you are a day trader, swing trader, it needs to be something more foundational that you would be basing your trading decisions upon. And that's where understanding the divergences when reading the charts come to play. So if you'd like to learn more about that, click the links below, okay, and take advantage of some of the courses that we've recorded so you can become a better trader. Now, here's why we did not short Tesla when everyone and their mother-in-law was doing so on Friday, September the 28th. Okay, so here's a chart of Tesla, okay? This is where Tesla closed actually on September the 28th. The light green dots actually represent a few trades that which we recommended recently to our subscribers. And again, a couple of those videos are posted on this channel. So we were shorting Tesla before this major drop took from 365 all the way to 300 level. We've also recommended shorting Tesla when that private tweet went out at 375. All the way back to 300. We've also locked in a 2,000% trade where you see this black candle formation right here. That was the day when Tesla dropped all the way from 280 range all the way to 252. And this is the alert that is described in this video when Tesla was trading around 298 area right here. The alert went out, and 2 days after that, it did fall close to 260, 265 levels. You can see it close to 264.77 on a Friday. So the average return of these trades combined is around 900%, guys. So if you're not subscribed to the alerts, make sure that you sign up. However, we're quite a bit different. We don't just want to have you sign up for the alerts, because that would not do you any good as far as progressing your trading skills. So And to be quite honest with you, we made it a requirement. Anybody that wants to sign up, whether you're signing up for long-term alerts or VIP day trading alerts, you absolutely have to take the chart course or you will not be granted the subscription to the alerts. The reason we do that is because we want you to understand the trades you're taking. If you understand the trade, we believe that you will be a much better when it comes to executing that trade. And clearly, as this example illustrates, we did send out the alert when Tesla was trading at 298. We did not nail the top. After we send out the alert, the trade actually has gone 2 days consecutively higher. And then it dropped $42. So if you were just taking the alerts, you might have been tempted to get out of this trade the next day. You might have been tempted to get out of the trade the following day. And if you did, clearly you would have missed out on this easy 700-800% drop, 700-800% gain in your option position if you would have missed out on this drop. So in order to avoid such situations, okay, first, take the chart course that talks about divergences, that talks about some of the best three setups, the best three patterns for shorting stocks, and then sign up for the alerts. To help you understand why we did not short a single contract of Tesla on a Friday, I wanted to go over this chart. I'm not going to go over everything on this chart, but I wanted to point out a couple of things. You see all these gap downs or gaps lower when the stock opens significantly lower than the previous day. Tesla is an extremely, extremely resilient stock. In other words, you don't see this type of history that I'm showing you here where a stock creates a gap lower and then shortly afterwards it actually closes the gap lower on the way higher. Here's another example of how Tesla stock gaps lower and shortly closes this gap on the way higher. Here's another example, okay, not so long ago, around September 10th, when we were locking gains on this alert that we sent out when Tesla was trading around 280s level and when it dropped to a level of about 252, 255 overnight. We actually did send the alert exactly the day before that move took place. As you can see, despite all the odds, okay, because in our view, this drop right here in Tesla, for anybody that has been following the stock closely, all the news that Securities and Exchange Commission was going to sue Elon Musk, they were already cooked in right here. So when this move comes in to some big institutional investors, it was not a surprise. It might have been a surprise from the standpoint of timing because many did not expect any resolution from the Securities and Exchange Commission till maybe 3 months, 6 months, possibly as an example with Mark Cuban, when he was dealing with similar charges from the Securities and Exchange Commission, it took out like 5 years for them to resolve the situation. So the resolution came in incredibly fast from what majority of the market participants expected. So and the fact that he was charged is something that was inevitably to follow the news which took the stock price down around the September the 10th. Now, notice what actually takes place. Now, there was nowhere nearly as much coverage on the Tesla stock around September 10th as there was on September 28th. But all the news and all the reasons why the stock was falling on September 10th, they pretty much already included the information that Elon Musk was going to be sued. As a matter of fact, when we were shorting Tesla stock right here at the 375 level, we were already saying that this tweet was not going to result in anything good for the company, that he was sending out that tweet from the standpoint of weakness. It was an attack on the short sellers. We saw through that, and clearly this is what developed since then. The stock, not quite half, but it lost close to 40% of its value since the video that we've posted in early August. So what do we see in this chart? Well, the point is, as bad as the media has made this thing sound on a Friday, the stock could have easily dropped below the level it set in September, but it did not. Now, the charts did not necessarily know that Elon Musk was going to eventually cut a deal over this weekend with the Securities and Exchange Commission. We didn't know that the funding secured was going to go down in history today as the most expensive twit, a $20 million twit, which, considering all the litigation costs that could have been tied up over the next 6 months or a year in resolving this matter, actually seems pretty inexpensive to get out of it. So even though it is historically the most expensive twit, it is actually a positive for the company in a sense that everything is resolved and Elon Musk remains the CEO. Now, there was a lot of noise about how Elon Musk was not going to remain the CEO, how they were going to bring somebody else, how they had no choice but to do that and all that stuff. So if you were paying attention to that, if you were influenced by what the media was saying on pretty much any sort of channel you could have turned on, that's all they were talking about, you probably did go and you shorted a bunch of Tesla shares or you bought a bunch of put options. Again, this is not the time to short a stock or to buy a ton of put options when all of a sudden everybody becomes incredibly bearish on something. That actually stands true as well when we're talking about a market where everybody is incredibly bullish or equally bullish and all the market participants see nothing but upside, this is exactly not the time to be buying calls. Two completely different examples that are exactly the reverse of each other, but the psychology and the mentality behind this are absolutely identical. So when we observed that Tesla could have dropped significantly, taken that low of 250, but it was definitely hesitant to do so, even though all the signals are there. Look, the volume on the sell side is the highest volume on the entire chart for the last 4 months. Okay, you clearly see a lot of signs the banks are actually coming in, and they did liquidate a bunch of shares on Friday. However, it should have been more of a dramatic move as far as the move of the stock price lower. It could have easily at least retested that 250 level, which it did in September, but it did not. So looking at this chart, as bearish as it looks, yes, there is a death cross here. Yes, there is acceleration in the volume on the sell-off. Yes, the MACD is about to make this move lower. So long-term wise, we're still incredibly bearish on the shares. However, we're not bearish on the shares in the near future. It's also important to notice that the number of calls purchased by institutional investors on September 28th was absolutely ridiculous considering the huge sell-off in volume, which tells me that a lot of institutional investors, even though it looked like the deal with the SEC was completely off the table, they actually knew something. Now, here's another thing that could actually take Tesla stock higher over the course of the next week. The delivery numbers are going to be out as early as tomorrow, which is Monday, October the 1st. These numbers could actually be good, which is further going to limit the downside of the drop. And potentially we could be looking at a short-term bounce. Now, how significant of the bounce? We're going to talk about that in just a second. So the key takeaways are these. We don't expect Tesla shares to continue dropping over the next 2 weeks. There's a high probability of Tesla shares trading in a range between 250 and 300. So in other words, if the delivery numbers are good, the shares could maybe rally back to the, you know, 280, 290, 300 level. We don't see the shares flying much higher above that. And we do expect Tesla shares to trade in that range between 250 and the 300 level over the next couple of weeks. Now, considering a situation with the bonds, which Tesla has to resolve in November, maybe in November we could have a further catalyst to relook at shorting Tesla stock again. However, in the near future, right now, we're not considering taking any positions on the bull side or the bear side in the stock. Another reason for that is we don't find the risk-reward ratio to be attractive. What do I mean by that? Well, the options premiums are clearly elevated considering all the bearish news and, you know, all the coverage that the stock has been getting. There is an incredible amount of premium that's included in the option pricing. So by definition, you would be buying them high in the expectations to sell even higher, which in our view is not a good strategy. You want to buy low, sell high. When do you buy put options low? You buy put options low when something is actually going higher and it is not absolutely evident to majority of the market participants that something is about to drop. If we use this definition, this situation right here does not fit that trading strategy. Number four, there is a number of great opportunities that are way greater in some other names besides Tesla that we think will deliver much greater risk reward scenarios. And feel free, by the way, to schedule a complimentary 20-minute trading options coaching call and get all your questions answered. If you're curious just some of the names that we're trading, sure, get on the call. We'll let you know. If you have any questions about trading options, if you have any questions about trading weekly options, get your questions ready, write them down, schedule the call, get your questions answered so you can have a clear view about what you're doing, how you're trading. And guys, if you really want to have a clear trading strategy, take the chart course. The links are in the description below this video. I wish for you to become a better trader and lock more profitable trades more often.